You decide, well, I need to start an airline. Where did that idea come from?
It came from, I was trying to get from Puerto Rico to the Virgin Islands. I was 28 years old, and I had a lovely lady waiting for me. And
and you went to the Virgin Islands because you liked the name Virgin, I assume, right?
Exactly. and that, actually, that's true. And anyway, American Airlines bumped us, and I'd been away from this lady for 3 weeks, so I went to the back of the airport. I hired a plane. I hoped my credit card wouldn't bounce. I got a blackboard. I wrote Virgin Airlines one way, $39 to BVI. I went to all the other people who were bumped, and I filled up my first plane. And when we landed in the BVI, the passenger next to me said, you know, sharpen up the service a bit, and you could be in the airline business. And I thought, okay. So the next day I rang up Boeing and said, do you have any secondhand 747s for sale? We started with one secondhand 747 against British Airways 300 planes and Pan Am and TWA's 300 planes. British Airways launched a dirty tricks campaign against us, and they did everything they could to drive us out of business. And we took them to court. We won the biggest damages in British history. It was Christmas time. We distributed it to all our staff. Equally, and so I think every year they hope the British Airways will launch a dirty tricks campaign against us.
So people like the fact that you were against the establishment airline, and well, one time I read that you that the what's now called the Eye, I guess it's the big Ferris wheel in London, the British Air was supporting it, and they couldn't get it assembled, and they couldn't actually get the thing to work, and you rented a blimp?
We actually had a little blimp company just outside London, and we scrambled the blimp and we flew over the eye that was still lying flat on the ground, and they, all the world's press were there to watch this eye being erected, and all we said was, you know, BA can't get it up on the side of the airship.
So how did the newspapers were able to
say that? We got the headlines. They
okay,
didn't.
Yes. So it turned out pretty well, and then you began building other companies. Did you always think that the name Virgin and your creativity could get them off the ground?
Well, again, the only reason we would go into a new sector is if we felt it was being badly run by other people. So the reason we went into trains was the government were running trains. British Rail was dilapidated trains. You know, a miserable service, and we just felt, you know, we could go in, we could get fantastic new rail stock, we could motivate the staff, and we could make a big difference. And so we took over, you know, the busiest line in Britain, the West Coast Main Line, and we've gone from 8 million passengers to nearly 40 million passengers, and you know, I think transformed the experience for people, and. You know, in every new sector that we've gone into, we've seen, you know, a gaping gap in the market where the big guys have not been doing it very well, and where we can come in and shake up an industry.
So, how many companies have you started with the name Virgin? Is it a few hundred by now?
It's in excess of 300.